Hi-ho, Bigglesworth!
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe I don't.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Dun dun dun! Hello and welcome to Hi Ho Bigglesworth. My name's Timothy Babblehump and this is Fallout 3. So I figure, seeing as Skyrim doesn't work anymore, I'm gonna play Fallout. I've never completed any other Fallouts, so I figured I'd just start with this one. Like, there is Fallout 1 and 2, but they're a different type of game and I'm not very good at it, so I'm going to play this one, the first of the 3D ones. Am I a boy or a girl? I'll be a boy. Yeah, I'll just be me.
It's a boy.
Me.
Oh. Boy, we've got a son, Catherine.
Indeed.
Beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James, we did it.
1 second. Let's turn on subtitles.
Beautiful son.
You've You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it.
Indeed.
Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
Right. Play a name? I'm not going to be called play a name, am I? That's a stupid name. Let's be called... Bugglebuff. Okay. Bugglebuff.
That's a good name.
Indeed it does, yes.
The gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
What am I going to look like when I grow up? There we go. That looks exactly like me. Yeah, that's what my character looks like.
Look like your dad.
I look nothing like you, you bastard.
Oh, very strapping.
Indeed. Now, you go ahead and die, Catherine. Go on.
Full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
I'm going to be a bastard.
Catherine?
James?
Catherine? She's in cardiac arrest. Start compression. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
She doesn't survive. I know that. 1 year later, I'm a baby. It's some generic, like, plot stuff. Yeah. Indeed.
Come on over here, son.
I'm a coming.
Walk to daddy.
Hello.
There you go.
Yeah.
My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro.
I know. Where's my toy, bitch? Give me a toy.
Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
I want the truck. Truck. Yeah, truck. The Great Escape. The ball. The ball. Oh, kick the ball around. Goalie! Okay. So I escaped. I've escaped. Yeah, okay. Look at the Your Special book. No. I want Teddy. Teddy bear. Teddy bear. Bebe. Teddy! Yay! Blah, 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 blah. Look at my teddy, people outside. I dropped it! I'm sorry, Teddy. I'm sorry. Oh, what are you doing, Teddy? Oh! I want the truck. Can I have the truck, please? I have a baby and I want the truck. Yay, truck! I'm playing with the truck. Brum. Sorry. Dada. Blah, 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 blah. Let's look at the Your Special book then. Activate. I'm special. Right. Okay, 6363967. Fine, yeah. Okay. Let's go and find my daddy. Daddy. I need the lockpick skill of 100 to pick this lock. I'm a tiny baby, okay? Let's just... The perfect crime!
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
I'm still in the pen. I haven't escaped. This truck was in here all along.
See that? It's your mother's favorite passage.
Yeah.
It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6.
Indeed.
I am Alpha and Omega.
Yeah.
The beginning and the end.
I don't fucking care. I'm running away.
I'm running.
Indeed. Bastards.
Right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
No, I'm hiding in the corner. I like to hide in corners. You can't find me. Fine. Come on then. Leave me alone, bitch. Da-da-da-da. Oh no, it's 9 years later. Now I'm 10. I am 10 years old. Indeed. Ah! Oh yeah, I've got blinded. That was terrifying. Help me, Dad. Help me. Indeed.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10.
I know, it's rushed by.
Congratulations,
it feels like only a minute ago I was one. How special this day is, do I? No. Who the fuck are you?
When you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities.
Piss off, I don't want a job, bitch.
As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000.
Thank you, Overseer Bob. Thank you.
You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Hilarious joke there.
You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Indeed.
Happy birthday!
Thank you.
We really surprised you, didn't we?
Yeah. Terrifyingly.
I was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
I know, I'm a dick, am I? You didn't fool me, I just pretended not to know. A lie. Great party, Amata. Thanks for doing this for me. Is this it? Or hasn't the real party started yet? I'm going to pretend that I wasn't fooled. No, I didn't get schooled. No.
You're such a liar.
Yeah.
Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday?
If it's not a donkey, I don't care. I want a fucking donkey, okay? I really have no idea. A date with Christine Kendall? Just give me the present already. Okay, I really have no idea.
Huh. I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages.
Okay.
I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once.
Yeah.
Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay?
Okay, let's do some mingling. Mingling. That's what I have to do. That's my official quest. Mingle.
I wish I was 10.
You have to work, though. You'd have to get a job. If anyone wants a tarot card reading, you know where to find me. Beatrice, indeed. Enter the annual Vault 101 bake-off. Bunt cakes only. Fine. Right,
Happy birthday!
I don't want to talk to you, bellend. Intercom, okay. There's no response. Fine.
Cut the cake!
I want a cake! Cake.
Ah. How's it going, pal?
What the fuck you done to my cake? I'm having a kid's party, huh?
Mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
You should be as well, Andy. Fucking robot nice. Breaking my cake. Hello, old nice lady father? Palmer.
10 years old.
Indeed.
My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
Yeah, as long as it's not a prune. You look exactly like a prune, you disgusting old bitch. Yes, ma'am. Oh, you didn't have to bring me a present, Mrs. Palmer. I hope you brought me something better than last year. Yeah.
Well, now, young people were more polite back in my day.
Yeah, and then they looked like prunes.
Of course, we had a real overseer back then,
yeah.
Worthy of respect.
Yeah, not that little bitch over there, yeah.
Over there with his rules and secrets. Why, I have half a mind to just up and tell you. Oh my!
But tell me, tell me the secret.
Old lady talk. And you're still waiting patiently for your present.
I didn't see any patience there at all.
But it is still your birthday. So here you go. A nice sweet roll I baked just for you.
Oh, sweet roll. Oh, yes. I'm gonna eat that sweet roll. Oh, sweet roll. Oh, I ate that sweet roll. It was tasty. Tasty sweet roll. Doesn't it? Fuck off.
Stupid robot destroyed the cake.
You don't deserve any cake,
sweet
bitch.
Roll you got from old lady Palmer.
Too late, I ate it, bitch. Mrs. Palmer said I didn't have to share since it's my birthday. You do look hungry. What, your mum drank... What? Your mum drank up all the ration coupons again? I threw it away, but you're welcome to eat it off the floor if you want. Mmm, it sure was good when I ate it a few minutes ago. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
I love those sweet rolls old lady Palmer makes. Stay out of my way, you got it?
I'm gonna punch him in the face. I
what
didn't...
What punch want? I thought you were in trouble there for a second.
Nothing, just wishing me a happy birthday. He wanted my sweet roll, but I told him off. The jerk tried to steal my sweet roll. Don't worry about me, I'm not scared of him. Yeah.
I know. He thinks he's so tough. One of these days, we'll figure out a way to get him back, okay?
Okay, we'll just break his neck and hide him behind the fridge or something. Where are you going, Dad? Dad, where are you going? Where are you going? Where do you think you're going, eh? Let's go to the atrium then.
Cool, right?
I should stay and enjoy the birthday party. I've enjoyed it. The everyone, shut up! Shut up!
Hey, Doc. We're all set down here.
Ooh.
Thanks.
Sounds intriguing. Okay.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom.
I know, I was listening.
I've been cooking up a little surprise present.
Ah.
Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
I don't think anyone will care at all. Indeed. Okay, let's go to the apartments. Inaccessible. Fine. Fine.
Happy birthday, Barry.
Hello, Beatrice. You're the tarot card person, aren't you?
I hope I didn't miss the party.
Yeah, my dad and Amata threw me a great party, didn't they? She's only just arrived. She doesn't know how good it is. It was quite shit in there, actually, if I'm being honest. I'm not a girl, and I'm not five, so stop calling me dearie. Yes, can I have my present now? Yeah.
Oh, boys will be boys, won't they?
Indeed.
Just can't wait to see your present, is that it?
Yeah.
Well, let's not keep you waiting any longer. I think you're going to like it. It's a poem.
Oh.
Just for you.
Shut up. Thank you, I will treasure it always. Is that all?
Of course.
I didn't even have to read the others.
And have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Shut up, Beatrice. Let's just have a look. What the fuck is this bullshit that she gave me now? It'll be in data, won't it? Radio? No. A birthday poem. Grey walls. Impenetrable steel. Suffocation. Condemnation. Little hands groping in subterranean uncertainty. Mummy? Daddy? Am I dead? Nay! Nay! Reborn into purifying fluorescence, a face emerges, strong and male. Father to me, father to all. Overseeing our lives, our eternities. Harshness of discipline, harshness of love. Obedience, my saviour. Lava to pupa, pupa to worker, buzz buzz. One with the steel honeycomb, 10 lies within, 101. Significant at last. Till grey seeps from walls to hair to soul. Then eternal slumber, the sweet sleep of incineration. That's a bit of a fucking morbid poem, isn't it? What kind of poem is that to give to a 10-year-old?
Enjoy the party, sir.
Bah. I only showed up because Amata's friends with the brat.
I'm standing right here, bitch.
4 minutes, and then I want that place cleaned up and everybody back to work.
Yes, that's locked, and yes, I can see you eyeing it.
Indeed. Right, hello. Hello, hello, people. Hello, who are you?
Here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
I thought dickheads were supposed to be shot on sight, but I didn't shoot you, did I? So shut up, bitch. I'm not a kid, I'm 10 years old. Can it, Jonas? Where's my surprise present already? Oh, but Dad told me it was okay to come down here. Yeah, can it, Jonas?
Oh, I see. Now that you're 10, you're all business.
Indeed.
Well then, mister, we'd better get to it.
Yes.
Happy birthday, by the way. Hang on one more minute. I think I hear someone coming.
Okay. Who could it possibly be? Out of the, like, 10 people who live in this place. Oh!
Are you ready for your surprise?
I was not expecting that. What kind of surprise? I don't like surprises.
Got it. I think you'll like this one. You're getting older, and you've got your own boy. I figure you're old enough for this, too.
Yeah.
Your own BB gun.
Oh yes, I'm going to shoot that fucker in the face. What was his name? I've forgotten it.
Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape.
Yeah.
It took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again.
Okay.
You know how tough it is to find a spring that
Butch, small? That was his name, yeah.
Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, yeah. What do you think? Want to give it a try?
Indeed. Yeah. Here? We can't shoot a gun here. What do I get to kill?
See now, it's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy.
I could kill someone.
Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me.
Okay, where am I following you to, bitch? That away! Through this door, okay. Okay. Right. So what am I shooting? What am I shooting?
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
Well, as long as I got BB guns. BB bullets. BBs. BBs. This is so great. Thanks. Thanks, Dad. Whatever. A shotgun would have been nice.
I'm sorry you feel that way. Maybe you haven't grown up as much as I thought. If you don't want it, I'm sure I can find someone who does.
No. It's mine. It's mine now. See, I got out, bitch.
Stop
Oof.
Around.
Sorry. I'm sorry. Let's shoot the targets. Aim. Okay. Let's get in the middle. In the middle! Oof! Yeah. Ah, die! Ah. No, I'm gonna enter VATS. Okay, yeah, this is fucking... I know how VATS works. Okay, shoot in the fucking head. No, shoot in the torso. No, in the face! Shoot in the face! Oof! How did you miss? There we go. You died, Radroach bitch. Yeah, I got one experience for that. Yeah, get it back,
Good
Dad!
Work. That's one less Radroach to deal with. Let's
Indeed.
Get a picture together. Capture the moment.
Okay, hey, let's John, do some capturing.
Get a picture of me with a big game hunter. Son,
smile. The rest. Yeah. Hello.
Boys and girls have different parts.
Do they now? 6 years later. I'm 16 now. Okay. You're looking at my eye, are you?
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. You have to go to class to take your goat exam. Come on now. You've got a goat to take.
I'm taking that goat, yeah. Where was my donkey? I wanted the donkey. Bye, Dad.
I got out of
Future imperfect. Indeed. So who's this? Who's this then? Whose skeleton's this? Whose skeleton, eh? Open framed quote, locked, average. I need lockpick skill of 50 to pick that lock. I don't have a lockpicking skill that high. Hello, Jonas.
Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
Yeah, and steal his bobblehead. Take bobblehead medicine. I found a Vault-Tec limited edition bobblehead. The inscription on the base reads, "The smart man knows a bandage only hides his wounds. Your medicine skill has permanently increased by 10 points. Take that, medicine."
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel
snake. What's going on out here?
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amada.
Let's high five, Butch.
Yeah? What do you want?
Yeah, I need to high five you for that tunnel snake comment. What's going on here? It looks like you're having fun. Tunnel snakes? You guys are some kind of gang, is that it? What's going on here?
Your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me?
Yeah. Speech 37%. Right, if you keep messing with her, the overseer's gonna come down on your gang.
Like I'm gonna listen to a little shrimp like you. Get lost.
I tried my best. Leave her alone or you'll answer to me.
And who are you? Her boyfriend?
I might be. I'm not entirely sure what happened in the 6 years between.
We'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix.
Okay. That's it, Butch. You and me right now.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Come on.
Come on, tunnel snakes. This twerp needs another lesson.
Yeah, come on. Where's my BB gun? I don't have one. I'm taking on all three of you, bitches. Die. Die. Yeah. Die.
Come on, tunnels.
Yeah.
Okay. You win.
Indeed.
We'll leave the little girl alone.
Yeah.
You're not
bitches.
Worth our time anyway. Come on, tunnel snakes. We're out of here.
Get out of it. Yeah. Go on.
You're the boss.
Yeah. No, they don't. There we go. Are you alright, Tomata?
Thanks for getting rid of them.
Yeah. You're not gonna ask how I am.
Why they won't leave me alone? Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go to class. Class. Hello.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me. It really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Fine. Oh, I'm feeling kind of sick, Mr. B. Guess I'll have to be scheduled. Sure, I'm ready. I bet I'll ace it. Come on, I don't really have to... let's take the goat.
Especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers.
Indeed.
We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
Okay.
Let's go, okay. People. The oversized patience is...
Let's sit here. Sit. Da-da-da-da. All right. Okay, come on. Bring on the goat test.
Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response?
Approached by a frenzied vault scientist, he yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." Okay, let's tell him that. But Doctor, wouldn't that cause a parabolic destabilization of the fission singularity? Or I could just say, yeah, up yours too, buddy. let's say that one. Okay.
While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door.
Oh.
The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do?
What should I do to the foot? Amputate it before it spreads. Scream for help. Medicate the infected area to the best of my abilities. Restrain the patient and merely observe as the infection spreads. Let's amputate it.
Question 3.
Amputation.
You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault.
Oh.
He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
A pickpocket off him. Pick the boy's pocket and take the stolen property for yourself and leave him to his fate. I don't even need to read the others.
Congratulations.
Yay.
You made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Designated Hitler? I really thought that said Hitler then. The Vault's designated Hitler. I've got to be that now. Why did I think it said Hitler?
She gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident.
Okay.
What do you do?
Demand my tea, bitch. You asked me to come over for some tea. And then she didn't give me tea, she gave me a pistol. Okay, obey your elder and kill the resident now. Offer your most prized possession for the resident's life now. Ask Granny for a minigun instead. After all, you don't want to miss. Throw my tea in Granny's face. Take that, Granny!
Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
Sounds like old Mr. Abernathy needs to be euthanized. Use a bobby pin to pick the lock on the door. Trade a vault hoodlum for his cherry bomb and blow the door open. Go to the armory, retrieve a laser pistol and shoot the lock off. Walk away and let the old coot rot. I'll pick the lock.
Question
yeah,
7.
And then I'll steal all the shit.
Oh no. You've been exposed to radiation.
Bastard.
Your mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
A bullet to the brain. Large doses of anti-mutagen agent. Prayer. Maybe God will spare you in exchange for a life of pious devotion. Removal of the mutated tissue with a precision laser. Let's do the laser thing. Yeah.
A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book. Issue
yeah.
1. You want it.
Okay.
What's the best way to obtain it?
Thievery, probably. Trade the comic book for one of your own valuable possessions. Steal the comic book at gunpoint. Sneak into the resident's quarters and steal the comic book from his desk. Slip some knockout drops into the resident's new Coca-Cola and take the comic book while he's unconscious. Let's do the sneakies.
Question 9.
Sneaky.
You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and...
Shit on the floor. No, okay. Loosen the bolts on some pipes. When the sink is turned on, the restroom will flood. Put a firecracker in the toilet. That's sure to cause some chaos. Break into the locked medicine cabinet and replace his high blood pressure medication with sugar pills. Manipulate the power wattage on his razor so he'll get an electric shock the next time he shaves. Let's do the one that might kill him.
Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
Can I not choose like David Hasselhoff or something? I'm sure he's much more important than the Overseer. Let's choose the third one down. I got a good feeling about that one. Yeah.
Well, well. Pip-Boy programmer, eh?
Hoorah!
Stanley will finally have someone to talk shop with.
Yeah, I'm a programmer. Okay. Wow, that's what I've always wanted to be. My dreams are finally coming true. Whatever I just answered randomly. Is that how you got stuck with your job? This can't be right. The stupid test got it all wrong.
Listen, yeah. I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously. Look where I ended up.
I know, you ended up being a dick, didn't you?
The whole test is a joke.
Okay.
If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
And slip him a bit of money, yeah? Okay, I don't want melee weapons. Okay, science. Yeah, we'll have science and sneakies. And let's have lockpick. Lockpick 12? That's because it got low perception, yeah. Okay. Do I want anything else? Repair could be... Yeah, no, that seems fine to me. Yeah, there we go. Okay, exit the classroom. There we go. Is that the end of all this tutorial-y shit? Indeed. 3 years later. I'm now 19. Yeah.
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
Okay. I'm awake, Kamata. What's going on now?
Come on! You've got to wake up!
There's alarms going off. What's going on? What's wrong, Kamata?
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
I didn't do anything. I might have done, because it has been 3 years, and I have no memory of what happened in them 3 years. What do you mean by that my dad is gone? Good for Dad. About time someone stood up to the Overseer. No offense. Big deal. Your dad's mad at my dad. What's that got to do with me? What do you mean my dad's gone?
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
He was always crazy. I saw that the second he started talking to me. I was like, what are you doing, bitch? I've never seen you so scared, Amata. What's happened? Dad couldn't have really left the vault. That's impossible. So Mr. Paranoid has finally gone over the edge.
God damn it! Stop making jokes and listen to me! Jonas is dead!
No!
You understand what I'm saying to you?
Poor Jonas.
My father ordered the guards to do it.
Bastards.
And now they're coming here to do the same thing to you. This is not a joke. You need to get out of here.
Okay. My dad can't have left. The door sealed shut. You're right, I can't stay here. But where can I go? You're the Overseer's daughter. Can't you fix this? Even if that's all true, how did you get here first? I need to escape the vault and you're going to help me. Okay.
Are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you?
Didn't tell me fuck all. No, of course he did. My dad tells me everything. It's none of your business. I had no idea he was planning on going.
Sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you?
Maybe. But now he's dead.
I can help you escape. I have my own plan.
Okay. Escape the vault? How? Not another one of your plans, Amata. I don't need help from anyone, especially not the Overseer's daughter. Let's go with the plans.
I don't have time to explain everything. You're just gonna have to trust me this time.
Okay.
Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it.
Easy.
His office. That's how I always get in.
Bobby pins, yeah, okay. Sounds like a good plan. Let's get out of here. That sounds awfully complicated. Why can't I get out the normal way? What makes you think this tunnel won't be guarded? It could be a trap. Sounds like a good plan,
One more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
I will need it. I'm going to shoot someone in the face with it. Thanks, Marta. I'll only use it as a last resort. I promise. Nice. This will come in handy if I run into any of your father's goons. No, you keep it. You may need it more than I do. No, I'm taking it, but I'll assure her that it's only a last resort.
Okay, I'll try.
I won't shoot her father in the face or anything.
Good luck.
Okay. Yeah. So that'll be the end of this first episode. I've done the introductory shit. Now it's time to fucking escape the vault. I've been Timothy Babblehump. This has been Fallout 3. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.